Okay, welcome to this gospel piano chord lesson. I just want to say thanks to one of my subscribers who suggested that I do a tutorial on gospel chords. I already have one tutorial out. I'll put it up here for you guys, but I want you to watch this because if you miss the idea that I'm going to present here, you're going to miss the whole idea of gospel piano, which is tension and resolve. Okay, there's kind of like some ugly tones. So gospel piano has lots of tension and resolve, so you have to get that down. And the shout out to that subscriber that mentioned that is Lino Grace. Hey bro, can you do some gospel tutorials? Well, you got it. Cool, a little jam session. Okay, let's jump into it. What we're going to go over today is we're going to go over a really cool thing that you can master pretty quickly. You have to have mastered your major chords, okay? So from the major chord, what we're going to do is we're going to play the same thing in both hands. So for instance, let's say you wanted to create a melody line of G. Just track with me, okay? I'm going to bring this all in really quickly. So a melody line of G, and you'd think, okay, in order to have my top note as a G, I need to play a C major chord. So what if I said you need to have a top note of this? B flat, you should know your chords. It should be an E flat major chord. So if you don't know your major chords, you have to master that. You can check out the basics for free on my website to get the basics of piano down. But from here, what we're gonna do is we're gonna kind of tweak this chord just a little bit, and we're gonna go in the right hand from here to here. Notice my middle note. Okay, make sure you track with me. I'm telling you, this is gonna sound amazing when we apply it to two songs. Okay, so track with me. So you have this going on, a C add two chord in the right hand. Okay, this is a major chord. And then in the left hand, all we're gonna do is we're just gonna drop the lowest note. So then you have kind of this C add two over E chord for this. Okay, so you go from the major and then to that transformation. Okay, now why is this transformation helpful? Well, what we're gonna do is we are going to take melody line notes, for instance, like in Yesterday by the Beatles. Okay, so do you see this melody line? So instead of just playing single notes there, we can do, okay, we could do stuff like that, or we can, that's a little advanced, so I'm gonna keep it more at something like this. Okay, what did I just use there? Well, does this look familiar? That's the chord I just showed you. Look at that. So I'm just basically taking the melody line, these notes here, and saying, how can I re-engineer this so that I'm playing that chord there? So the thought process here for Yesterday is you have the melody line on C sharp. So what major chord in root position has the melody line of C sharp? It would be F sharp here, what I just played. Okay, so you have F sharp here, and then what are you supposed to do? In the right hand, you're supposed to add two. So the way you can think of this, adding this note here, is you just know from your bottom note, it's just a half step and then a whole step up. Okay, so you have that. And usually you can use your ear to figure this out. In the left hand, it's pretty easy. Just drop the lowest note. Okay? There's our first chord for that. So let's substitute just that. So instead of just playing the single note, we have the full note, and what we're doing here is we're creating tension. Okay, it's kind of a little bit more of a beautiful type of tension. There's some chords that have way more tension, but that's for a little bit more advanced of things. If you can master this little trick here, okay, if you can master that little trick, it will really help you master tension. Now, to close the video out, I'm gonna do one more video.
Okay, not video, I meant one more song.
And by the way, if you guys want me to focus on something else, another tutorial, make sure to comment below. Let me know what you guys are interested in. And if you're lucky, like Lino Grace, I will do a tutorial on what you ask if I have enough upvotes for it. So let's take Here I Am to Worship. Okay, this is a very famous like 90s song. Okay. Okay, so why am I choosing this song? It's not very gospel-y, but let me show you that if you add in a little bit of a nuance of this kind of tension with this chord, if you add that in, it kind of brings this gospel-y side out of a very not gospel-y song. So check this out. So the melody line, we got to pay attention to it. So here I am to worship. So look at my highest notes. Okay, so let's do it here. Okay, so let's do it on this one. So these two notes here. We're going to create a chord around that to give a little bit of tension, and then we'll just drop into the next chord. So we're coming from this A, so and then into the E. So how would that sound? And then I'll break it down for you. So it adds a little bit of tension, a little bit of kind of wonder and change up. There's a change up. People aren't going to expect this change up that you throw at them, and it's a subtle one. It's not anything too crazy, you know? It's not something that's going to completely throw everyone off. Okay, it's very subtle. So the notes, as we mentioned, so on this G sharp here, how are we going to do that? So you have to create a major chord with the top note of G sharp. Pause the video, try it yourself. Okay, so it's C sharp minor. I'm sorry, C sharp major. And so I actually played this incorrectly, because if you notice, in the left hand, we're just going to drop the note here. In the right hand, we're going to go add two. So what I did when I was showing you guys this is I actually played the minor. I did. Okay, but really, instead of playing this middle note here, I should have played it here. Okay, so that'll sound really cool. Sorry that I messed that up. Okay, so that's the first chord for our top note melody line. The next melody line is going to be F sharp. So what major chord in root position has F sharp as its top note? Well, B major. Scales to get this down. So then the right hand's going to transform into B add 2, left hand is going to drop the root, and then you just have B add 2 over E flat D sharp. Okay, so the two chords, here we go. How beautiful that is. I hope that this lesson was really helpful, guys. Make sure that you understand how to use tension. A really easy way to create tension is using this chord, substituting some of the melody lines like we did. But that's advanced. We did more. Okay, and then in this song that we just did here. So I hope that the tutorial was helpful, guys. Remember, it's all about tension, tweaking the chords just a little bit so that you can get your gospel sound, that tension, that resolve. It's boring just playing the same things over and over, so see how you can apply this song. As I mentioned at the beginning of the tutorial, leave a comment below on what you'd like me to cover next. Maybe I'll choose your topic. As always, guys, make sure to subscribe, and if you're interested in exploring my online video courses, you can click up here. I'll catch you guys next time.